Could banning fast food restaurants near schools solve the obesity crisis? One major city seems to think so. London has a new policy prohibiting fast food shops from opening within a quarter mile of city schools. Now, this city does, London, has the highest rate of overweight children in England. Here in America, incidentally, a recent study finds that more than half of US children will be obese by the time they're 35. Sobering statistics. And so, could banning fast food near schools play a role in this? Because when you start to read about what kids are consuming at school, maybe they're onto something in London. I don't know.
That's a lot of fish and chips, right?
Right. Well, in London,
it's too simple to just say, oh, because there's fast food nearby, that's why the students are more likely to be obese. But a study did look at students at schools within a half a mile of a fast food restaurant. They consumed fewer fruits and vegetables, they drank more soda.
Exactly.
And I can see as a student, if you can very quickly go get a fast meal, are you going to do that? Get the fries and soda with that? Or are you gonna eat the banana that your mom packed
in? Right, and I think it's judgment. But I think this is a tough one because they did try this here in Los Angeles and South LA, and they basically instituted a similar ban. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, that ban was on any new freestanding fast food restaurant coming up, and it didn't work at all. And the problem was there were already so many existing poor choices. Yeah. And I think if you're going to implement a policy like this, it's a really nice idea, but you also then have to replace it. Well, you're not going to have fast food, but you're going to implement affordable, healthy options within that quarter mile or half mile,
that's,
or it's just going to fall flat.
That's where South LA fell short.
There's
a big difference between the geographical settings, logistically, it may be next to impossible to implement those healthier options easier. I mean, unfortunately,
I think that's part of it, it's cheap to eat fast food. Let me throw this out there.
We just had a segment where a geneticist is virtually able to map the entire genome of a baby, what they may or may not be at risk for. When are we going to be able to say, okay, all these fast food restaurants, they still make fast food, but they make it healthier? Because I don't understand. I eat healthy, but I eat foods that are very much like the fast foods that we all eat in society. I don't go home and eat plain kale and twigs. I don't. I go home and I'll make a burrito that is incredibly healthy and scrumptious. To me, tastes better than anything you get at a fast food restaurant. When are we going to allow the food scientists to come in and make fast food so that if kids choose it, which they will, humans are going to continue to eat fast food. The only way to solve this to me is we start to have more fast food restaurants make healthier meals so the kids know it's good and there are more healthier options.
In the school setting too.
Absolutely.
That the school offers tasty but healthy food.
Well, I think one thing that would be amazing would be if all these fast food restaurants used their purchasing power, where they're buying all these foods in bulk, to bring down the cost of affordable, healthy options.
You're seeing this happen in some of the big stores like Walmart, they're making organic produce cheaper. You could see the same thing in fast foods. But what's interesting is if you look at kids' behaviors, they just want to eat food that tastes good.
Yep. Right.
So for them, whether it's healthy or not doesn't matter. But if it tastes good, and it can be healthy, they will eat that.
Good. And if the cost comes down too, it's much more accessible.
And why? But it gets back to also school cafeterias. There are some really interesting projects where school cafeterias have revamped their menus to make really healthy food, but food that's good. Pizza that's maybe thin whole grain crust, and kids are like, wow, I'm eating pizza for lunch. Again, they don't care if it's healthy or not, they just know that it's good. I think we need to be more proactive than the whole stick of we can't have any fast food restaurants around here. I'm telling you, if you made good food in that cafeteria, kids would not leave to go hit these fast food restaurants. Let's think about this for a minute before we go to break. If there is a prediction that potentially half of all kids could be obese by the age of 35, we're not winning right now. There was a nice little plateau effect a few years ago, but we got to be more creative, right?
Absolutely. And we know that obesity, it's dietary, and we know that kids are exercising less and more sedentary and time on the computers. But I mean, we also agree that diet is the biggest issue.